Hey, what's up? Chin here from Code and Quick Tips. Today was a new video about a technique called box-box collision. So first of all, what is a box-box collision? It's basically a way to detect if two rectangles, like those two, are colliding or not. Today I will only cover the not rotated collision, because if you rotate both rectangles, it gets much harder to do, and in most cases you won't need it. First of all, we must decide what a rectangle is in our code. Therefore, I have created this picture. You can see that every rectangle has a top left corner coordinate and a bottom right corner coordinate. And coordinate is always an x and a y. So the rectangle number 1 got an x1 and y1 and an x2 and a y2. That's the same for the second rectangle and for all other rectangles. To represent this in our code, I have created a class called box, or you could also call it rectangle, and in this I will save the x1 and y1 and the x2 and the y2 as you have seen in the picture. I also save the width and the height because it's much easier to draw it then. In the constructor I just give all the values the correct value, so you just paste in some coordinates and you get a box. I also added a render method so that we can actually see our boxes, because otherwise it wouldn't be so good for testing. I just fill a rectangle at the given coordinates with the given width and height. I also added some getter and setter methods, so that we can get the coordinates of the top left and bottom right corner out of the rectangle, and that we can reset the position later on so that we can move around the rectangle. In our actual game, I have created two box objects from type box. I init them in the init method with some random coordinates. And as you can see here, I call the render methods with the given arguments, so that both rectangles are rendered. I also added some code to the update method, so that we can move around the second box to our mouse position, so that we can actually test our collision code later on. Therefore, I get the mouse X and mouse Y, and just set the position of the second box to the mouse X and mouse Y. Right now, our program can just render two boxes and we can move one around with the mouse. As the next step, we want to check if they are colliding or not. To do that, we won't check if they are actually colliding, but we will check if they are not colliding, because if we know that they are definitely not colliding, we are sure that they are not colliding. In all other cases, they will collide for sure. Therefore, we must just differentiate between four different cases, and that's the first one. In this case, the rectangle 1 is over the rectangle 2. Therefore, the y2, so here you can see the y2 of our first rectangle is smaller than the y1 of our second rectangle. To represent this in our code, I will create a method called collide, where we can handle the collisions. The method collide will return a boolean, because we want to know if it's whether colliding, then we return true, or if it's not colliding, then we return false. So collide, and the method will take another box, because we want to check the collision between two boxes. As I mentioned here, we can just do the first case now. So if our y2 is smaller than box dot get y1, we can return false, because we are sure they are not colliding. As a next case, we can see this case where our x2, so that is the x2 coordinate, is smaller than the x1 of the other box. Then our box is definitely left of the other box, and it's not colliding. So we can write here, if x2 is smaller than box dot get x1, then we're sure that we are not colliding and we can return false. So let's go on to the next case. We can actually see here that the x2 of our or let's start with the y, that our y2, as we can see here, our y2 of the other rectangle is smaller than the y1 of our rectangle. Because of this, we are sure that they are not colliding, because the second rectangle is over the first rectangle. So we can write, if our y1 is bigger than box dot get y2, we are not colliding. So on the picture we can see, our y1 is bigger than the y2 of the other rectangle. Now we can do the same thing with the x coordinate. If our x1 is bigger than the x2 of the other box, we are not colliding. So we can write, if our x1 is bigger than the x2 of the other rectangle, we are not colliding. In all other cases, we will collide for sure, so then we can return true. Here we have set up a basic collision method. Now we only have to implement it inside of our update method to check if the rectangles are colliding or not. To do this, we can add a simple if statement where we say if box 1 collides with box 2. Now the method will return true if it's colliding, and in all other cases it will return false. I will just change the color of our boxes if they are colliding so that we can see if they're actually colliding. To do this, I just get the graphics out of the game container and reset the color. I will set the color to red. In all other cases, when they're not colliding, I will just set it to a default white. If we now test our program, we can see that the rectangles turn out red if they are colliding. So with this code you can basically do all the stuff you need, for example for a basic platformer where you can do a jump run, or for a top-down game you can use the circle circle and box box collisions to handle things like collision with level or collision with enemies. So that's no problem, one simple if statement and you can check the collisions between two objects. If we now would add more objects, we would just see if any object collides with any other object. Yes, that's it. I will put all the source code in the description, so you won't need to just rewrite everything, because I think that's pretty awful. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you do so, you would help me a lot if you could give me a thumb up, or if you want more you could subscribe for me. That would be really cool from you. If you have any suggestions for me for, let's say, other videos, you can just let me know in the comments. I will make a video about all teams that you want to see in my videos. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.